All right, you're good over here.
Never go out. Because remember I told you Peraza made a video why they don't have to read the Bible and why they don't have to go out. You know?
Why you don't have to read the Bible.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Wait a minute. Guess where he is. You would never guess where Peraza is.
Hold on, let me guess. I was about to say something crazy too. He's in Somalia.
He's in Mecca.
Mecca?
He's in Mecca.
God, what the fuck? Are they gonna kill his ass? Yeah, how you go to Mecca? Saudi Arabia? You have to get a religious visa. Because that country is closed off.
Hell yeah.
You gotta get it. The only way you get in there.
If I heard you correct, that's what he said.
I was actually watching the show yesterday. So the only two ways you get Saudi Arabia is with a religious report.
A special passport.
Yeah.
That's crazy. They always had Saudi Arabia locked in. And that ground, within miles around that unholy temple, if you ain't a Muslim, you better not step foot on that motherfucker, they'll kill you.
Oh yeah, that's not bad.
Yeah, within it's like a 20-mile radius. You step foot on that motherfucker, you're dead.
Hey, let me read this real quick. 2 John 1:10. If there come any unto you and bring not this doctrine, receive him not into your house, neither bid him Godspeed. For he that biddeth him Godspeed is partaker of his evil deeds. So that tells you, because if somebody else teaches a different doctrine, you're not supposed to come together with them. Does this say come together? It just don't say if they're come to you with to bring out this doctrine, they kick it with him. It don't say that. In the joint forces, it don't say that.
You know when somebody talks, they contradict their own selves? The whole conversation is full of them.
Yeah, I don't know.
But he was trying his best to be cool. He was trying his best to be cool, though.
He coming with that bullshit doctrine, not the scripture.
And the dude that was speaking was a heathen. The one I know from Lifetime Fitness, the heathen.
Oh, he's still up there?
No, I ain't
gonna go. No, I'm talking about you, dude.
Oh,
yeah, he wasn't out there?
No, he was out there.
Oh,
one of them was out there. The one that's a heathen was out there.
Hey,
if he ain't a heathen, he just got a foul ass fucking spirit on you, man. I have to, you know, you can always tell a heathen. And that's what I'm saying, the motherfucker was a heathen, man. Read another scripture. It was a blessing running into the motherfuckers, man.
That's
with a loudspeaker and shit, nobody around, they in the middle of the hood.
I remember I was at Horizon's church years ago, and he told us that we can't blame Esau for anything. He said, you got to blame yourself. I mean, which is true to an extent, but he was like pretty much cursing out for teaching about Esau. Like, you can't blame Esau for nothing. Like, who else are you supposed to blame?
This is Isaiah 52:8. watchmen shall lift up like the voice. With the voice together shall they sing. For they shall see eye to eye when the Lord shall bring again from them.
Yeah, that's when you'll see eye to eye. So when we get in the kingdom, then all Israel's gonna come back together. Until then, all you're gonna have is a little small sanctuary. You know what I mean? Just little spots, little oasis. The whole world is a desert. And when you go through a desert, you lucky if you see an oasis. And you get lucky, because there's a lot of mirages. When you walk through the desert, you see a mirage over the horizon. Oh, there's water.
Yep.
You run into it, boom, there's no water. You start trying to drink the sand. You know what I'm saying? During the cartoons, they start drinking it. They're drinking sand.
Right.
That's how these guys are out there. Because a lot of y'all following after the wrong teachers, right? So y'all out there, you ain't even got the oasis. You got a mirage. It's just an illusion. You got no truth. You got no water. No life. Dude, that's that dried up with the fruit. Oh, hey, they gonna get cast forth because that withered branch, they gonna get burned up. Yeah, that withered branch ain't got no life in it, you know what I mean?
This is Philippians 1:27. Only let your conversations be as becometh the gospel of the anointed, that whether I come and see you or else be absent, I may hear of your affairs. That ye stand fast in one spirit, with one mind, striving together for the faith of the gospel.
Now, that's a beautiful scripture right there. I used to read that again.
Yes, sir.
That's a good one.
Philippians 1:27. Only let your conversations be as it becometh the gospel of the anointed, that whether I come and see you or else be absent, I may hear of your affairs. That ye stand fast in one spirit, with one mind striving together for the faith of the gospel.
That's how we in one mind and one faith. Is that keep going, though?
I can keep going.
Yeah, that sounds good.
And nothing.
But we all together in one accord. You ain't gonna see like one person out here celebrate Christmas, one person believe in the virgin birth, the other doesn't. One person believe in reincarnation, the other doesn't. We all have to agree on everything. Otherwise, what's the point?
Tuesday,
stupid shit downtown. Like we sports fans, and I'm a Steelers fan. You're a Bengals fan. It ain't talking about stuff like that.
Nah, it's talking about, you know what I'm saying? It's talking about the doctrine, the teaching.
People are simple, man.
They really are simple.
Can you continue this? In nothing terrified by your adversaries, which is to them an evident token of perdition, but to you of salvation in that of the Most High. For unto you it is given in the behalf of the anointed, not only to believe on him, but also to suffer for his sake.
Yeah, right, because we suffer. You know, I mean, we catch all kinds of hell for teaching this truth. You come out, you can start teaching. Your wife might leave you. Family will turn their back on you. Old friends got a problem with you now. Actually, we got a problem with them. You know what I mean? If your boss sees you out here teaching, or your co-workers see you teaching, you can lose your job. They're like, this guy's whacked out and crazy. We're like, I'm firing.
Or the spirit.
Yeah, because the scriptures, they could get cut. Because you know what I mean? If you got a lot of antichrists out here, people who, you know, they hate the word of the Most High. So if they hear you teaching the Bible, they get greatly offended.
Having the same conflict that you saw in me, and now here to be in people. That's it.
Galatians 6:6. Let him that is taught in the word communicate unto him that teacheth in all good things.
Yeah, in all good things. That's what we do. We teach in all good things, no bad things. Actually, bad things are good things, right? What's bad for the wicked is good for us. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like that destruction covenant.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's what we have. That's going to be beautiful and at the same time terrifying. Oh, there's some with East. That's why we seen that guy dressed up. Look, there's people wearing shirts. Oh. Yeah, because yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Maybe the pavilion. We even see the dude dressed up like actual like Angus Young. The dude was walking down the street wearing the schoolboy outfit with the gay as hell. No. With just some random guy, it looked like
you. I'm talking about Angus Young. Did he die?
No, he's not dead.
I thought he died.
His brother got a stroke or something. Malcolm.
Right.
No, the one that died was the old singer. The first singer. Is there an AC/DC concert?
Yep.
Was that a pavilion?
Nationwide.
Oh, Nationwide. Because they got Axl Rose doing vocals now.
You kidding me?
Oh yeah,
that came out like a month, 2 months.
Yeah, their shirt said Axl. Now that's the hottest ticket in town. Axl, he sounds good with him, actually. Is there an old singer at it, though? But yeah, but AC/DC, that's what tells you some people don't know. AC/DC, that's slang for homosexual.
Oh!
That means you go both ways. You go AC and you go DC. And right, and there's a famous, the original singer, Bon Scott, they had a famous performance on New Year's Eve back in the 70s where Bon Scott dressed up like a woman and he went trans. And when people try to say I'm lying when I say AC/DC means they're homosexual, but the dude dressed up like a woman. You know what I mean? Oh yeah, well he looked like a woman, don't he? He got long hair.
Ecclesiastes 12:14. For the Most High shall bring every word into judgment, with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be
evil. Hey, that's his tongue.
Yeah, because he tells lies like a snake. That's why the tongue goes in two different directions. He says one thing, but he means something else.
Never goes to the internet. You go to the internet, don't you?
You're watching the YouTube.
Go to YouTube, or you go to World Star Hip Hop.
Yeah, he's trying to jump up and down on that one. Yeah, jump on it.
For the Most High shall bring every work into judgment, with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. Everything's coming out.
Yeah, all this. That's like, yeah, when you go and talk about politics, why all the dirt on the politicians are coming out? Like your girl Hillary. Everybody knows she's a criminal, but she's still running for president. Right. And you see, now you got all kind of people that know about the Illuminati. What? Yeah, don't mess with that, bro.
What's that?
They know about, what's up?
What is it, dude?
Now I know DC.
What is it?
Wherewith shall a young man cleanse his way?
Oh.
Listen, that's a good scripture. How you come up with these beautiful scriptures? Listen to this. They be coming out with this scripture, boy. Listen to this. I asked you how you get clean, right? You gonna pay attention? Listen.
Psalms 119:9. Wherewith shall a young man cleanse his way?
How does a young man clean his way? Keep going.
By taking heed thereto according to thy word.
By taking heed to the word, by listening to the words of the Bible, to the men of the Lord, who are the word of men of the Lord. We're supposed to listen to our word.
I'm a pastor. I'm a preacher. You know what people in church? You know what people in church hear me? That's the evil.
Yeah, they're evil.
They're evil.
They're liars.
Deceitful devil.
They're just there to take your money.
Right. Take you in the back room.
Yeah. The preacher, if the preacher says go in the back room with me, don't go. Don't take his candy.
That's right.
He's trying to trick you. Sometimes you wonder why you pray to the Most High, you know, he kills your baby mama because she's a whore
and
an adulterer. But you got to understand, at the same time, he could be preserving her for something greater.
Something better.
What you talking about, sweetie?
She said, no, I think she's talking about the government and parents.
Check this out.
It's not going to be right now.
But it's coming soon.
It's very soon. It's soon.
No, listen, they got to be 7 years of peace before because it's...
Yeah, that's that old... Yeah, that's that old Trinity Broadcasting Network. But listen to this script.
I'm going to start at Joel 25. That the triumphing of the wicked is short and the joy of the hypocrite.
So, yeah, the joy of a hypocrite for a moment. So, it seems like this shit we living in, this hellhole, is gonna last forever, but it's really just for a moment. Go ahead.
Though his excellency mount up to the heavens, and his head reach into the clouds.
Are they not in the heavens? They have satellites, spaceships, you know, this great technology. Go ahead.
I call that Big Brother.
Right, it is Big Brother. It is.
Yet he shall perish forever like his own doom.
So he's gonna perish forever like his own doom. So he's gonna perish just like that turd when you flush it down the toilet.
Flush the toilet, you don't see this shit again. UPS don't deliver it back to you.
No, neither does FedEx.
Don't nobody keep it. You're like, oh, I like this one. I'm gonna keep this one in my collection.
It was like that movie, Joe Dirt, whenever that big
thing. Oh, yeah, Joe Dirt. Yeah, that's a good one.
All right, Joe Dirt.
Yeah, I heard it was part two coming out.
Yeah, he shall perish forever like his own dome. They which have seen him shall say, where is he?
Right.
Gone.
He was flushed.
So that's what's coming. That's what's coming, this time around. It's going to be death by fire.
The flood.
The Lord flooded the earth. But now he's going to flood it with fire.
He shall fly away as a dream. He shall not be found. There's some dreams that you don't remember. Right? Some people don't never remember their dreams.
Right, we'll wake up in the kingdom of heaven like, oh my God, that was just a nightmare.
Oh, yeah. He shall be chased away as a victim of the night. The eye which saw him, no more. Neither shall his place anymore be told him. His children shall seek to please the poor, and his hands shall restore their goods. His bones are full of the sin of the youth, which shall lie down with him in the dust. Though wickedness be sweet in his mouth, though he hide it under his tongue, though he spare it and forsake it not, but keep it still within his mouth, yet in his meat and his bowels is turned. It is the gall of acid within him. That reminds me of that Jesus was trying to tell him, if it's meat, it's vile.
You know about that devil, right?
He's the biggest one of them all.
Look, what Jews you lose, he's a so-called Jew. Those are the number one devils on the planet Earth. So-called Jews. They're not even real Jews, you know that? I get revelation.
I'm going to tell you, listen to the song by Megadeth.
Yeah, that's a good song.
The earth starts to rumble and the world powers fall. A warning for the heavens and a peaceful man's hand fall.
Yes,
that's my girl. She goes to the Megadeth.
So that means we can say that.
Is it seven all day?
Well, I'll tell you what's going to happen. The next thing is coming that has to come before the end.
God says, don't have because he'll let you down.
You know about the mark of the beast?
Yeah.
Before the destruction comes, they're going to implement the mark of the beast. They're going to start implanting everybody with a microchip.
I know. That's what they talk about. But you know what? It's not God's plan. That's man's plan. Just remember that everything that's going on right now is man's plan.
Well, the Most High controls everything. There's no free will. We don't have no choices.
But you know what? This is a test right now from God. Who's going to fight? Who's not?
That's right. That is correct.
Just think about it.
The Lord says, blessed is he that overcometh and keepeth my works in stead.
But you know what? I hate to put aside the I'd love to go to the bathroom. I got to find me.
Where it go?
I had drank 3 bottles and this much, and I'm like, oh.
You got some vodka in there?
No, it's all water. Not bad.
You got some gin.
Yes, it did. Some Seagram's, some 7-7.
It's all water. I got my jug here that I put my water in. Because I've been up at the Greek festival, I sell the homeless people.
Oh, yeah.
So I have to bring my chair because I can't stand for a long period
of time. I know how that is.
I got to go up here to the Ohio Theater and sell some more over there, and then I'm going home.
Joel 33 and 14 for the Most High speak at once.
I come.
Day twice.
You guys have a good day.
And then Grim
is calling me.
I'm coming all day.
Is that still going?
I'm just clowning, man. The Most High speaking voice.
She crazy, bro. She busted out the Megadeth, bro. She knew it word for word. She did it like Dave Mustaine dropped the prophecy on her. I mean, they had that prophetic word, but she know that by word for word, but she don't know the scripture. But she said that he had 7 years of peace. That's the crazy shit our people believe in, man. Bugged out shit. Man, that's that Left Behind shit with that Kirk Cameron movie. Not Left Behind. I'm thinking the Knowing was good.
Yeah, but the other one.
I'm talking about the Bible, the Christian in that movie. Yeah.
But Nick Tank made one.
Was he?
Yeah, he made one.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, Left Behind.
Really?
Yeah. The UFOs came to
I never watched
that. He got Left Behind.
I never watched
it. Huh? The first one was on. I don't know.
I never watched
it. There's 3 of them. Yeah.
I never watched that.
Oh, it was a bad movie, though. It had me cracking up, though. In a dream, in a vision of the night, deep sleep falling upon him, suffering on the bed, upon the bed. Then he opened the mirror of the bed. Only got that because she said that he was
this. Yeah, she said, man, she said this is not God's plan, this is man's plan.
Right, right.
I mean, it's not like we're a man.
She got it wrong.
Yeah, right. Because there's no such thing as a man's plan. The Most High controls everything.
Yeah.
Every last little tiny little dot and atom and molecule.
Yeah.
Yeah, everything. The Most High controls everything. Yeah. Everything goes. Everything goes.
Right. 18:3. The Lord only is righteous and there is none other but him who governeth the world with the palm of his hand. All things obey his will.
All things obey the Lord's will. Just like when during the time of the Exodus, Moses kept saying, let my people go. And the Pharaoh, going against all logic and reason, the scriptures say that the Most High hardened the Pharaoh's heart, right? That the Most High controlled the Pharaoh. It said the Most High hardened the Lord, hardened the Pharaoh's heart, which means he was controlling what the Pharaoh was doing. So just the same thing goes today. The Most High controls George Soros. The Most High controls Evan Rothschild, okay? He controls all these. He controls Hillary Clinton. He controls Donald Trump. He controls us.
For he is the king of all. By his power, dividing hosts among them from the train.